The White Yellow Cross represents the largest non-profit organization for home nursing in Flanders. That's the northern part of Belgium. We provide a 24/7 patient-centered home nursing care and over 150,000 home care situations. To ensure this service, we call on 6,000 well-trained healthcare professionals and an extra staff of 3,000 employees. We ensure also 24-hour service for personal alarms, allow people to call for assistance if they have an accident or fall at home. For our organization, technical support is very important. I give you briefly two examples. To help people continue living safely in the comfort of their own home, we need reliable lifeline alarm systems. This can be achieved by a personal alarm system installed in the home or by mobile devices also usable outside. And a second example shows the importance of technology. Due to the COVID pandemic, we all become a lot more reliant on technology to communicate with our patients. In that respect, we introduced very quickly video consult for the following up of our diabetic patients. Technology and digital tools can provide discrete home monitoring, allowing older people to remain independent longer. Wearable devices can monitor vital signs at home and can alert healthcare professionals if deviations occur, so they can intervene earlier. Connected cognitive homes and wearables and smartphones are also enabling older people to managing their long-term conditions more effectively. This way of monitoring allowed healthcare services to be delivered remotely. All those measures can save us costs. Not yet, but we intend to explore the possibilities. We are currently preparing a research project on how we can better monitor chronic patients using mHealth and online tools, for example, video consult. We will also investigate how we can develop demand-drive care, where patients controlling and coordinating the delivery of healthcare in accordance to their needs. We haven't experienced yet, but I think there is a need for correct definition of an open platform. For many healthcare organizations, this is a difficult concept because many of them do not understand exactly what this means. Is it open in terms of technical integrations, the so-called APIs, or open in terms of the exchange of data, or the use of open standards to increase interoperability, or is it a mix of all this? This is also often the misunderstanding that open is less secure in terms of GDPR or the protection of personal data. I hope this project brings some clarification on this subject.